where our samples used to be. This is whatever we could take off, and these are the remnants of it. Various samples were in different stages of processing. Some we had just started. The older samples, which had been collected since 2015, had almost reached their last level of checking for their signals. And within this 8 months, everything is gone. So a lot of five PhD scholars, I can say, have lost their work. Years of work.
ये हमारा जो लैब है TLOH लैब, ये 2016 में बना था. काफ़ी मेहनत से इनको हमारे प्रोफेसर ने बनाया. तो ये इंडिया में कुल ऐसे 12 सिर्फ लैब हैं और दिल्ली में सिर्फ एक यही है. तो ये काफ़ी एक मतलब इम्पॉर्टेंट लैब है इस फील्ड में पैलियो क्लाइमेट के. तो इसको TLOSL मतलब लुमिनोसेंस डेटिंग के लिए यूज़ करते हैं हम लोग.
दिस लैब एसेंशियली बिलोंग्स टू CSIRD व्हिच इज़ इन द स्कूल ऑफ सोशल साइंसेज. यू नेवर फाइंड अ लैब व्हिच इज़ सो neglected in the entire of JNU. Look at this, like, we cleaned this out by ourselves, and since then nobody has even made the effort of removing all of this. And these have our destroyed samples, which we have unfortunately had to throw away after years of processing. I mean, this is it, like, you know, I couldn't have, like, pictures do speak more than words.
लैब जब से बनाए उसके बाद से इस लैब में जो दीवारों में सीपेज वगैरह था, उसकी वजह से काफ़ी डैमेज, मतलब पहले से हमने काफ़ी रिक्वेस्ट किया कि इसको रिपेयर करने के लिए, पर कभी रिप्लाई आया नहीं. और इन लॉकडाउन के दौरान इसके बाद हमें मतलब फोर्सफुली घर भेज दिया गया. उसके बाद हमें बार बार लिखने के बाद भी अलाउ नहीं किया गया. तो उसके वजह से क्या हुआ कि ऑलरेडी जो डैमेज था, तो उसके वजह से ये डैमेज, क्योंकि कोई इसका केयर करने वाला था नहीं, तो डैमेज इतना ज़्यादा हो गया और इसके अंदर जो सैंपल्स थे वो ऑलमोस्ट सारे डिस्ट्रॉय हो गए. और सैंपल्स में हमारे JNU के स्टूडेंट्स के सैंपल्स भी थे हम लोगों के, और बाहर के यूनिवर्सिटीज़ भी इसे यूज़ करते थे.
वी हैव बीन राइटिंग मेल्स सिंस 2015. माय प्रोफेसर हैज बीन राइटिंग मेल्स. वी हैव द रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ ऑल ऑफ द मेल्स, बट जस्ट पीपल डिड नॉट आंसर एट ऑल.
I was about to start my OSL sample processing back in March, but then we were notified by the university to go back home. And now it has been over 8 months and we still have no access to the lab. Some of my friends, they have sent pictures to me stating the present condition of the lab, the fatal end it has met due to no maintenance at all. I had a complete breakdown. Because I am a final year PhD student who is supposed to submit in few months. After seeing this, I don't see my work going any further. I don't see any timely submission of my thesis to which I have given years of my life.
A magnetic separator which separates different constituent materials of a particular sediment. So this we have had to repair on our own because it started rusting. Because of obvious reasons. Okay, if they're not going to answer to our questions, then don't know what to do.
My work is on reconstructing glacial phases and paleo environment in the part of Upper Bias Basin, which is near Solang Valley. So basically what we do is try to reconstruct how the environment or the climate was in the past based on the glacial advances. And for that reason we need to understand the morphology of the place, and from understanding the morphology we collect the samples. We collect soil samples, we collect rock samples, and also we try to collect some carbon samples.
और सबसे जो बड़ी बात है इस डैमेज में, सबसे ज़्यादा जो नुकसान हुआ है कि ये जो सैंपल्स थे, जिनके भी थे, ये काफ़ी रेयर सैंपल्स थे. इनको आप अभी रिट्रीव नहीं कर सकते. इन सैंपल्स मतलब हिमालय में 5,000-4,000 मीटर हाइट के अबव सैंपल्स हैं, तो वहाँ जाने में काफ़ी लॉजिस्टिकल एफर्ट लगता है, काफ़ी ज़्यादा डिफ़िकल्ट टेरेन है, रिस्क भी है और काफ़ी ज़्यादा जो है मतलब उसके लिए पैसे चाहिए होता है. तो अभी जो लॉस हुआ है ये पता नहीं कौन भरपाई करेगा और इसके लिए हम किसको अकाउंटेबल ठहरा है.
दिस लैब वाज सेट अप एज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ कंसोर्शियम where 4 universities were involved, and it was funded by the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. So the entire purpose of this lab was to facilitate dating facility.
In March, I left the campus because I was actually forced to leave the campus. Wardens came to my room, wardens and all the security came to my room, and they insisted that you leave the campus. Mess is gonna get closed, and no one is gonna be there.
ये सिर्फ और सिर्फ JNU एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन का नेग्लिजेंस है जो हमारे लैब को मतलब आज इस हालत में पहुंचा दिया है, क्योंकि इन्होंने जब लॉकडाउन के बाद इन्होंने एक डिस्टिंक्शन कर दिया कि हम साइंस के स्टूडेंट को मतलब अलाउ करेंगे लैब यूज़ के लिए और सोशल साइंसेस को नहीं करेंगे. तो हमारा ज्योग्राफी के स्टडी का नेचर इंटर डिसिप्लिनरी है, तो इन्होंने हमें अलाउ किया नहीं बार बार रिक्वेस्ट करने के बाद, और अभी जाके देख रहे हैं तो सब कुछ ऑलमोस्ट बर्बाद हो चुका है. इसको अभी कौन रिपेयर करेगा, कोई क्लियर कट रिप्लाई आ नहीं रहा है.
So with my own pay, whatever money I was left with my scholarship, I started renting a place. I started buying food, which cost me around 15,000 per month. And I waited till November, but writing every day and everything, but no one responded. After that, they didn't insisted. And then finally in November, when my slot in IUSC was getting over, I was very desperate. I was in desperate need. So I tried to come in, but naturally I couldn't. In December I just snuck inside the campus with my I was caught by my wardens and everything. Anyways, I said I have to stay, I can't go out, I don't have a place. So they were a little bit sympathetic at that time and they let me stay in my room. When I come inside the next day, when I try to find my samples, I can't find them. So I started cleaning the lab because there was no maintenance.
So when this lockdown was going on, time and again we had been writing letters to our I wrote to my chairperson seeking permission that please let me access the lab, but I did not receive a reply. My senior did receive a reply from the registrar where he denied her permission to come in. So there is obviously this science, non-science, artificial non-science, science binary that these people have been playing on. But it's very unfortunate because it's us students who are having to lose it, our years of research. We've had samples from various different places, from Birbal Sahani Institute of Paleoclimate, and we have had samples from us. So like our own thesis samples, they are lost. 4 years of processing, which we have done. We have been going to the field in the midst of flash floods. Sometimes we can't go to the field, sometimes we go to the field and bring down the samples, and you don't even know whether your samples are safe inside a lab within JNU. So there's a lot riding on it. Like, I do not know whether the administration are aware of the fact that we're not passing our time here, we're doing serious work, and this is about high time you take cognizance of the fact.
So when I came back, I saw like all is wasted except the rock samples. So right now I have like the pre-processing I told about CRM samples. You can do that in our lab also, because it doesn't need, because we have all the facilities here. So right now I have to go every day spending my money, 60 rupees up, 60 rupees down, 120 rupees plus lunch there and everything. I have to spend money there, just because this process takes 2 months, so that students don't have to face this difficulty in this university. That's why this facility was done here, and now we can't use that, and we are again spending money. My scholarship, I haven't received it. I had put in the application since September, I haven't received it, and I was supposed to get money from last November. So I have no money, and then warden comes to my room and like, you are from other, like you are not from science student. I'm like, my lab gets destroyed, then what do you expect me to do? You expect me to stay outside? What do you expect?
We could probably like take a look inside, where we can see some of the effects of the seepage that we are talking about, which has taken off the split AC. We run our machine, it's called the Lexic Smart machine. We date sediments in this machine. We generally have gone as far back until the Quaternary period. But it's extremely useful in studies of the paleoclimate, I mean the Earth's past climate, and as well as for archaeology. In this lab, we basically did processing for 3 different kind of tests, which is exposure dating, optically stimulated luminescence, and the third one was that we also did sample preparation for AMS dating, which is radiocarbon as well. But unfortunately, our center, CSRD, is under social sciences. When the JNU administration had allowed all the science scholars to come and use their labs, they did not allow us. So what has happened is that previously we students, we were taking care of the lab by ourselves. We were doing the termite treatment wherever necessary. We were putting waterproofing wherever it was necessary. But unfortunately, with this entire 9 months lockdown, in fact, the lockdown in JNU has never ended. It's still going on. So in this 9 months, the lab has not been visited at all. My professor used to come once a month to do whatever termite spraying he could. But the damage is far too much, like to save years and years of PhD work for some.
और ये अभी हम जो जो एफर्ट हम कर रहे हैं एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन के नज़र मतलब रिक्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं बार बार अभी, तो ये सिर्फ हम अपने लिए नहीं कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि ये लैब जो है, हमने पहले ही बताया कि ये देश के 12 लैब में से एक है और दिल्ली में शायद ये ऐसा सिर्फ एक ही लैब है. तो इसको पूरे ऑलमोस्ट काफ़ी सारे यूनिवर्सिटीज़ के स्टूडेंट्स स्कॉलर्स इसको यूज़ करते हैं. तो ये हमारी जो अभी जो हम कर रहे हैं ये सबके लिए कर रहे हैं. ये ऐसा ना समझा जाए कि हम सिर्फ अपने लिए कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि इसमें सैंपल्स जो भी डिस्ट्रॉय हुए हैं काफ़ी सारे और भी स्कॉलर्स के डिस्ट्रॉय हैं जो दूसरे इंस्टीट्यूट के हैं. काफ़ी पुराने सैंपल्स भी डिस्ट्रॉय हुए हैं.
It's not only for us CSRD students, but it's for the entire of the nation. Whoever wants to come and get their samples processed in far lesser money than they would have probably done from other research agencies. So far, the other luminescence dating facilities in India are part of research facilities, never a part of a university. This is the first time that is this kind of a facility is a part of a university. These are trees growing on top of the lab, and which has been allowing seepage inside for the last 4 or 5 years, ever since the lab was established. And if you try to repair the wall right now, the entire wall will go. We have had to, because of this regional reason and the seepage of the water, we have had to lose one of our double distillation plants. This we have replaced by ourselves, and no responsibility was claimed then. This is our fume hood. This was supposed to be very state of the art back in 2016, but this is the condition right now. We have lost our magnetic stirrer. And this has entirely happened because if somebody would have had, like, if there was an inquiry committee, like, you know, who'd like a committee which would be in charge of taking care of all of these labs. And I did mention the drawback, we are from social sciences. So they are talking about this entire interdisciplinary studies in their education policy, but in practicality, they don't even have the means to support the existing facilities.
I'm associated with TL and OSL lab, which has been completely destroyed, you know, during this lockdown period. I was staying away from the campus, and when this lockdown started, I was stuck out of the campus with no access to the lab, to the campus, to the library or any academic resource. Now it's been more than going to be more than 9 years. My sample has got completely destroyed because it was in the center, and I have no resources with me. I'll have to go back to the field again to get the samples done, and I don't know whether I'll get the exact sample from the same place or not. And if I'm not able to get the sample, there is no point of completing, you know, doing my PhD.
Tungsten covering repaired by ourselves, like, and since nobody is taking responsibility, what to do? Okay, you don't even know whom to ask the reparations from. You keep writing shooting mails to the rector, to SCMM, to different people, but nobody seems to own up to it. And I'll show you the reason why. Because they have kept whole lot of scrap for the last 5 years on top of the ceiling and never bothered to clean it. This entire lab is basically an investment exceeding 2 crores. But the machineries were under serious threat because of the lack of attention from the JNU administration for the last 4 to 5 years, when we have been writing emails time and again for proper maintenance of this place, but nothing has actually happened. So basically, this is where the radioactive strontium 90 gets stored here. These are the condition of the wall. You see that multiple trees are growing there. and all of this may fall and our centrifuges will be gone, our jaw crusher will be gone, our everything else that is already being rusted will be gone. So apart from the infrastructural damage, there has been so much of time that we spend for each of these samples. We spend months after months processing each of these samples, and we have had samples from Sagar University, we have had our own samples, we have had samples from IIT Roorkee, we have had samples from Cincinnati, from North Carolina, all of them which were trusted with us because we work in this lab.
Yeah.
They're all gone and we are answerable right now. In fact, this is not our fault at all. Like, it's completely JNU administration and the mismanagement they have been doing.